Well, I'm working on the Lister D today. It's high time it had an overhaul. It had a factory overhaul way back when, but it's worn out again and well overdue some attention. This is the crankshaft, and I'm going to try and show you how to replace the bearings, but first of all we'll remove it from the housing and I'll show you how to do that as well. You can see it's got a hardened steel sleeve on the crank pin, and we're going to replace that as well. So first thing you need to do is remove the front cover. It's just a dust cover. I don't even think there's a gasket with it. These are usually full up with grease and muck. Someone has put a gasket on this one. So this is an oil return ring. The idea is, rather than having a seal as such, the oil is fed back into the housing by this little gadget here. And what you've got is this little snap ring around it. In there somewhere is a screw. There it is, just there. So we need to get that out. In practice they're often stuck, so we may have to heat it up. You can also see the first of the crank bearings. So the screw is located just there and the snap ring is just to stop it turning. Very simple. We'll see if luck is on our side today. It would appear it is. An impact driver might be useful there if it is stubborn. So now we're going to remove the crankshaft from the housing. This is honestly the simplest way to do it, and you'll do the least damage to anything. Whoever built this engine at the last overhaul wasn't particularly careful by the looks of things, and they've just clamped the crankshaft in a vise without soft jaws. It's so easy to do. I mean, I've got two strips of soft metal here that I just clamp in. It always frustrates me somewhat when people don't make that little bit more effort. Anyway, it means I've got to make a bit more effort and just run a file across some of those burrs and a bit of emery paper to finish off, and that bearing should come off without too much drama. What Lister do at least provide you with is a couple of little holes here so you can drift it out. That's all it takes, really easy, and I won't do any more damage to the crankshaft. Just as a by the by, someone's obviously drilled out the key at some time. Not entirely satisfactory, but it's what we got to work with. See, the crankshaft is now deburred enough at least to get the bearing off. I've just used some fine emery cloth to clean it up a little bit more, and that should be enough. I don't know how well you can hear that, but fairly raunchy. The other bearing's also very easily removed from the housing. So at this point we're ready to tackle removal of the holding sleeve that's on the crank pin. You'll need a decent pair of circlip pliers to release the snap ring. As you can see, I've just got it released. It's a bit of a fiddle to do, so I can just pop that off. So next we'll just clean up all the oily muck that's in there, and we'll have to heat this up, and with any luck we can then pull it off. Failing that, we can grind through it most of the way and then split it with a cold chisel, but there is always a risk of damage if you do that. Ground through it most of the way, so all we should have to do now is give it a smart tap with this. Having removed the old sleeve, we're going to heat this one up nice and hot. We're going to get one go at it, so I've deburred the shaft as best I can. Just done with this fix. I've got a block of aluminium that's nice and soft, so we can gently tap it home if it needs it. It should, in theory, just drop on. That part of the job's finished with the snap ring reinstalled. It can be easiest to fit one of these by hand. You don't need circlip pliers to fit them again. Usually hook the split end over the slot and then you can ease the other end round. It's a little bit fiddly, but it can be done. Now we can fit the first of the crankshaft bearings. One of them needs to be fitted in the housing, but one of them you can fit to the crankshaft. That is the larger one, and the size of that is RLS14. I'll tell you the other one later on. I usually start this kind of thing, a bit of grease on the shaft. You don't need very much, but just a little. And when you put the bearing on, when it's warmed up, that will just help it drop into place. That's now as far as we can go with the actual crankshaft itself. Really is as easy as that. If you get it hot enough, a little bit of grease just drops on. So we'll let that cool, and then before we actually put it in the housing, we'll pack a little bit of grease around the bearing to get it started, as it were. It'll be a while before the oil gets through. So this bearing is an RLS12. It's been in the freezer, the housing's been heating up. I think that'll go in there quite nicely with a bit more heat. Thank you. So despite the bearing being in the freezer for an hour or so, and the housing heating for about an hour as well, it's still pretty hot. It wasn't quite enough and I had to drift it in. The important thing is to tap around the outer race, not too hard, but don't hit the inner. Because as soon as you're hitting the inner race, you're impacting the ball bearings against the race in which they run. If we just turn it over, you can see it's fully home in the housing, which is what we want. So while it's still hot, we'll get this fitted to the crank. So the housing, all the surfaces that have got to slide together have been greased, so it is now ready to assemble, so far as I can see. I'll try and do this as best I can so you can see it. So that's it assembled. It was just a case of very gently tapping the bearing races into place evenly. You can see it rotates nice and free. If I could have got a bit more heat into the housing, that would have been better. I suppose you could put it into the oven, get it even hotter, but it wasn't too bad. So we got the crank pin to install, which is a push fit, and the little oil return ring to put back, and the oil return cover. And that's pretty simple, so I won't film that. But I'll... I've got the small end of the connecting rod heating up. The two new bearings are in the freezer compartment where they've been for a couple of days.